Kohima police gunned down one ex-army personnel in an extortion case while arresting his accomplice near old MLA Hostel Junction in Kohima around 4:30 p.m. yesterday evening. The extortionist Kehuto Asumi was a former Havildar in the 164 Infantry Battalion of the Territorial Army, and his accomplice Netoi Awomi from Lizutomi Village were reported to be extorting money from shops using the name of NSENK. Kohima police reported that efforts were made to apprehend the two miscreants with the use of minimum force, but things quickly escalated out of hand as the police personnel pinned the extortionist down when he tried to reach for his firearm. In the melee, the accomplice tried to snatch one of the police personnel's firearm and a shot went off, hitting the miscreant on the left side of his neck. He succumbed to his injuries. Seven more NDRF personnel reportedly tested positive for COVID-19 in Itanagar yesterday. The personnel are returnees from Nagaland, Maharashtra, Bihar, Manipur, and West Bengal, and it is alleged that the NDRF kept their travel history hidden. The first positive case was detected on June 16th, and he was already suffering from mild symptoms when his swab sample was collected on June 15th. He was among six personnel who had returned from West Bengal after concluding duties related to Cyclone Amphan. With the seven fresh cases, the total number of positive cases among the NDRF personnel has reached 22 as of today. The four NPP MLAs from Manipur, whose agreement with the Congress brought the BJP-led Manipur government to the brink of a collapse, were taken to Delhi yesterday, along with their party chief, for urgent discussions with the BJP's senior leaders. This development happened while a CBI team flew into Imphal to question Congress leader and former Chief Minister Okram Aibobi Singh over an alleged Rs. 332 crore scam. According to sources, a deal with the Manipur unit of the NPP, which has blamed the rift on the BJP's alleged high-handed ways, has been worked out. It will, however, still need to be approved by the BJP's central leadership. Under Phase 3 of the Vande Bharat mission, national carrier Air India will ferry 150 Indians from six northeastern states still stranded in Kyrgyzstan on June 30th. Of these, 70 people are from Manipur, 67 from Assam, 8 from Arunachal Pradesh, and 2 each from Tripura and Mizoram, and 1 from Meghalaya. Parts of Northeast and adjoining East India, particularly the states of West Bengal, Sikkim, Assam, and Meghalaya, are all set to receive a fresh monsoon spell of extremely heavy rains starting Thursday, that is June 25th. The Indian Meteorological Department has issued orange alerts over sub-Himalayan West Bengal and the rest of the northeastern states between Wednesday and Friday, June 24th and 26th.